So my mother makes this for me. This is bhujalokya. If you travel back home, the security at the airport, they will not allow you to take bhujalokya in your hand baggage.
Literally, like, considered anthrax.
You can use bhujalokya as lethal weapon.
What's up, guys? My name is Nikhil and you're watching Many Pieces, the show where we go around my house and try the best food that I can order home. Because this freaking pandemic ruined everything, okay? I was going to restaurants for free and eating free food, and now I have to be home and eat free food. In today's episode, we're going to be trying food from the beautiful state of Nagaland, along with a few other dishes from other parts of Northeast India. My guests for today are two incredible actors. You've seen one of them in movies like Rangoon and Mary Kom, and you've seen the other in FOMO Shorts Please and Margarita with a Straw. And today I'm going to be dining with Lynn Leishram and Shayani Gupta, who both featured in Akhuni, a slice of life film set in Delhi that I watched on Netflix and really loved. And so I'm very excited to meet with them and dine with them, even though it's over a Zoom call.
Hi guys.
Hi.
I wanted to tell you guys, I just watched the film, but before we can talk about the film, I think it's important that we address the name of the film.
Akhune means strong smell. It's basically fermented soya bean that is used in many dishes in the Northeast, but because it's fermented, it really stinks.
Yeah, it's a very unique, funky, pungent smell for sure.
I mean, if you see the film, you will see that I was actually cooking it. I spent so much time with the akhune that I started smelling like it.
So today we have a gorgeous spread of primarily Naga food prepared for us by Josie's Kitchen.
Hi, my name is Josie Paris. I am from Mizoram. So I picked up a lot of main dishes from the Seven Sisters, like the pork with akhuni from Nagaland, like Iromba from Manipur. In my kitchen, I am trying to bring the most authentic Northeast food. That is the reason why I get all my vegetables and ingredients sourced from the Northeast. I want the mainlander to feel and experience the Northeast food as authentic as possible with the limited resources that I have.
So I'm excited to dig in. Lynn, since you're from Manipur, can you tell us which of these dishes we should start with?
Nikhil, you should try akhune because you've never tried. So this is the smoked pork with akhune. This is what we actually had in the film, guys. So Nikhil, you're one of the very lucky people who've seen the film and who's tasting what it is actually. So akhune chutney, rice, and the akhune pork. Okay guys, bon appetit.
Oh my god.
Very balanced, very good.
I don't think I've ever had anything that tastes that in my life. And there's a level of spice after it, and I can feel it heating the inside of my mouth. Why do people in the Northeast love their spice?
I think it's because of the weather also. Geographically, we are like a little secluded and it's a little colder. And the spice keeps you warm. Humidity kam hai udhar, so I think it releases, I don't know.
Don't tell me people eat spicy to sweat it out, man.
It's a pasina aata hai khane se. Also, chili has, it increases your metabolism.
Yeah, that it does. And green chilies. You know, if you see, this is a lot of green chilies. But this pork is insane. Oh my god.
Let's move on to another chutney sort of a thing, this pork liver.
Lynn, are we having it with rice? Or
everything has to be had with rice because it's very strong. Your stomach's gonna
move. She's saying it almost like, do it, watch it.
I love liver, but I have never had pork liver, I have to be honest.
Oh yeah, I've never had pork liver either.
So it's a first for all of us.
As children, do you remember any like local street food places that you used to go to?
My school, there used to be these kuchka walas, and instead of eating in the canteen, I used to stand right next to the canteen across the railing and eat kuchka. So therefore, years I have eaten like 40, 45 kuchkas every day during lunchtime.
Oh my god.
Every day.
What about you, Lynn?
We used to have this aunties who would sell sinju, fried peas, okay, and pakoras. The way of preparing pakoras over there is very different. So it's like tempura. Then, oh my god. And you would give a bhujalokya.
Oh my
kata.
God, wow.
Lynn, what are we having next? I'm hungry.
This is iroma. It's aloo, beans, and a lot of mirchi and fermented fish in it.
I mean, it resembles sort of a Northeastern khichdi. But I imagine with every passing month, the seasonal vegetables change, so the taste of this would change.
Yeah, so iroma, usually we use the stem. Out of that, we make iroma. So it adds a lot of flavor. I can see Nikhil.
Sorry.
Sorry. It's very spicy, Nikhil.
Yeah, the iroma tastes like very mild and savory. And then when you swallow,
yeah,
like this lava.
Now I can't eat without green chilies in my meals. Like I eat,
she goes to French restaurant and she'll ask for green chilies.
No, I've heard of friends carrying like a bottle of Tabasco in their purse, but nobody who carries a jar full of chilies.
I am a real auntie. I have green chilies and safety pin in all my bags, okay?
Yeah. Oh my god, Shani.
Okay, what are we eating next?
She has sent something like this, which is like a sinju chutney, karela with onion and stuff like that. This is not very spicy.
What I really like about this dish is the black sesame. I'm not a fan of karela, but recently I've grown to love it. Are there some foods growing up that you hated, but now you just like really you've grown to appreciate it?
I hated akhune.
Oh my god.
Really? Because my mother, she is a akhune fan. Like our fridge used to smell of akhune. If I made ice cream or if I stored something, it's like that smell of akhune, okay?
To me, it's like a really lovely smell. Like it talks to your sensory.
I find it so funny and poetic that your childhood trauma from the smell of akhune resulted in a film.
This movie, like, you know, and also I learned a lot about akhune and where it comes from and how it's made and where, what, all of that, you know. So, and now I've started loving it and I'm going to eat it right in front of you now.
Now we're going to try some smoked pork and bamboo shoot.
This is naga bamboo shoot. These are like strings, you know.
This is nice. The bamboo shoot.
Yeah.
In the architecture industry, they're all fanatics for bamboo. It's used in furniture, it's used to feed pandas. It's so fascinating to see that it's also used in food. So sustainable.
Yeah. I just love it. Oh my god.
The pork is so tender.
So try it with akhune chutney.
Lynn, mixing the two. Flavor explosion.
It's so different.
Oh, wow.
Which pork do you prefer? The akhune one or the bamboo shoot one?
I know my answer. It's the akhune one. It's a lot stronger than the bamboo shoot flavor.
Wow, we have a convert today.
What about you guys, same?
Mine is the bamboo shoot with pork plus the chutney of akhune.
It's all so good. I'm very confused.
I asked between the pork and the chutney.
Akhune pork then.
Booyah! Okay, we have one last dish. Bhoot's Jalokia chutney. I want to ask you guys a little bit about the film before we destroy our taste buds with the chutney. What are some fun food memories from set?
We didn't really enjoy the set food, so we used to order from this place called Heritage. Everything Naga and very simple. We used to eat breakfast, lunch, dinner, but I wanted Naga food every single day. And we used to go and tell them ki khana ready rakho, hum package leke jayenge. Shot ke beech mein bhi.
Wow, take away.
Every day.
Like, how do you deal with people judging your food?
Yeah, there's a dialogue in the film, which is that you have the right to cook your food, but they also have the right to not smell your food. I guess that's there, but we have to be a little more sensitive towards each other.
I think the film really did really well was in a very nice way show the racial prejudice towards people from the Northeast.
So I think it exists everywhere, every culture, you know, not only about Northeast. You know, South Indians are clubbed together as Madrasis or, you know, South Indians. So, and that's not right.
And the fact that we could do a film like akhune and again start this conversation because, you know, in a country like ours, don't you think we are so incredibly fortunate that we can actually, you know, have so many different kind of cuisines and we are very, very lucky and we should sort of exploit that more.
Food is one thing that we, you know, people connect with majorly.
People have realized, people have seen a little bit of what is our culture and, you know, in the film itself. Like, you know, a lot of people came up to me and random people wrote apology saying that I'm so sorry that without knowing calling somebody a chinky or a momo or a chow mein would hurt so much to somebody. There should be more films like this for people to understand our culture.
Thank you guys so much for sharing this delicious meal with me and introducing me to such a Indian cuisine, but also an incredible culture, set of cultures. I want to say thank you to everybody. And I'm going to do the outro while eating this Naga ghost chili because I didn't eat it.
Oh no!
Okay, I'm going to take just this much.
Oh my god!
You're supposed to eat it with rice! Oh, Nikhil!
Oh my god, Nikhil!
Hi guys, thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you enjoyed this episode, please be sure to leave a comment telling us what kind of cuisine you want us to try next. Oh my god. Oh my god. Please go watch Axon. Oh my god, I said Axon. I completely forgot. Because of. Oh my god. Guys, just go watch the movie, please. Subscribe to Netflix and our YouTube channel. Thank you.
Lynn is an amazing cook, and she doesn't cook one or two things, okay? She cooks multiple things, like, and she cooks in large portions. There is so much food left, and then she's gonna force you to take it back home, and they'll never bring back the tiffins because she's like, "Tu leke ja." But next time, Lana, because फिर से खाना लेके जाना पड़ेगा, and Nana invariably will obviously carry our tiffin boxes back, you know.
Lynn, you're my favorite type of person.